Nosebleeds, medically known as epistaxis, can catch us off guard. However, they're often quite harmless and can usually be managed easily. Today, we'll talk through the proper way to handle them. But before we proceed, bear in mind that while most nosebleeds are benign, there are exceptions. If a nosebleed is intense, it continues for over 20 minutes, or it pairs with other symptoms, one should seek immediate medical help. It's important to note that if someone is on prescription blood thinners, their risk for continued hemorrhage increases significantly, as these medications can intensify bleeding and challenge the standard control techniques. So it's important and recommended that these patients seek further medical attention. So now, let's look at treating the patient. First, reassure the affected person and urge them to stay calm. Ask them to sit down and lean forward slightly, as this helps keep the blood from trickling down the back of the throat. A backward tilt could lead to a potential complication like aspiration and vomiting. Once you're gloved, or if the individual can do it themselves, pinch the soft section of their nostrils just past the nasal bone. This should be held for about 10 to 15 minutes without releasing pressure. This simple act applies pressure on the blood vessels of the nose and helps facilitate clotting. If there's any blood pooling in the mouth or throat, we can instruct them to spit carefully rather than swallow. It's important to contain the blood spray or splatter through this process, which can be associated with sneezing, coughing, spitting, or speaking. Eye protection along with face shield may be necessary along with gloves to fully protect the care provider appropriately. If there's no PPE available, be sure to stand aside the patient, not in front of their face, as this may help protect the provider. It's important to note that while a cold compress can help constrict blood vessels, cold blood does not clot swiftly. If you choose to use an ice pack, it is suggested to be placed on the bridge of the nose or the rear of the neck. Once bleeding stops, encourage the patient to resist the urge to blow their nose, as this can dislodge the clot and cause the nose to begin bleeding again. One common misconception is to pack the nose with gauze or tissue. This should be avoided in a first aid scenario, and remember, only a physician should decide on medical nose packing. And for those patients who may be on blood thinners, the pressure might need to be maintained longer and a physician's intervention may be needed. Utilizing these first aid methods, most nosebleeds can actually be managed easily. But remember, persistent bleeding, recurring episodes, or additional symptoms or complications may warrant prompt medical attention via 911.